National ESL Game of the Week, game number two, OGB going up against Complexity, which is EC, because they used to be Epic Charmanders, now they're Complexity Gaming, nice pro team coming up here in the rankings, but game number one was taken pretty easily there by Epic Charmanders, Complexity Gaming, and it's basically the same team, except instead of this time we had that Alistar band, instead we're going to have that Evelynn. Now, we do have OGB, similar kind of heroes, again, we do got that Malzahar, as well as the Soraka Ash, but now we have a Taric and Corki, and we're going to have to see what they can do with it. Lots of flash going down. Is it another 10 flash game? It is another 10 flash game. And
yeah, definitely. Flash is very strong, so.
That right there is Colby Cheese. Now, Colby, tell us a little bit about what we think we're going to be seeing these lanes, because OGB has an interesting team lineup.
Yeah, okay, so OGB is built to counter Complexity this time. You're going to see the Malzahar going probably top lane with Taric so that they can push hard and make the Evelynn go to the lane, because if they can take a tower down, then they're going to have the buff control and they're going to have dragon control, and that's what it's going to come down to. And then you're going to see the, of course, the Corki going to be going middle. He's going to be fine. He's got an escape with his, you know, with his little jump, with his little jump back, and so he's going to be fine. You're going to have probably a decent lane bottom as well. It's going to be Ash and Soraka versus let's see who's bottom. Poppy and Cho'Gath, I guess. Yeah. So it's going to be difficult. Again, they're not going to be able to do a lot of harass. Ash is just going to have to focus on farming. It's going to come down to Corki and, you know, top lane with Malzahar pushing that lanes really hard and trying to get that control over the game.
All right. So, wow. Okay. Yeah, we'll have to see if any of that comes true there, Mr. Colby. Impressive as always. But right now, OGB is, they're nice and bunched up here in the mid. Oh, there we go. We have a clairvoyance going off. We do see, hi guys, you're over there by that blue, protecting that nice and pretty. And I did notice that Evelynn has that smite, and we don't actually have a dedicated jungler over here at all.
Yeah, that's it's interesting because you know, while they don't get that jungle XP, they're gonna win the lanes anyways, and they can go pick up jungle anytime that they'd like. I mean, later on in the game they're gonna be high enough level that you don't actually have to have a smite to pick up stuff like that, so they'll be fine. And then later on in the game, whenever they're in fights, they have an extra summoner now that's gonna help them out. So whereas, you know, one of them would have had a smite, maybe they have an extra flash or a knight or something like that now. The Evelynn knows that she can't be getting off early ganks as well, so she is actually picking up these small golems so that she'll be level 2 right away. And that way she can do a little bit of extra damage and maybe a little bit more lane control as well.
I don't know. We just had Ash. The Ash-Soraka combo, again, going to be going down south. And we just picked up the Wraiths. It does look like Corki is going to go mid with that Urgot. Not too surprising Urgot's there. But Lightning is also doing a little bit of a roam here in the jungle. So we're not going to be seeing that jungle Taric. I think he's just looking around for that Evelynn. But you said Evelynn took out those golems and probably going to go grab that blue.
Evelynn is actually about to gank Istvaan.
Stealth
because it's only 10 seconds at level 1, so she wasn't able to do anything useful there. So she's going to try and do some roam. And very nice. He was just waiting for her. Very good job. Not going to be able to take him out, probably.
No,
I'm sure that she's going to be fine. But that is going to stop her from ganking as effectively. She's now, you know, just over half health, and she's going to have to be careful. Good thing about her now is that she is level 2. She's going to come up here. Her stun is going to go down on that Taric. She's in kind of a bit of trouble if this cannon can't get in there, but he is coming in here to pick up some damage on Istvaan. However, she's going to have to be careful. That little Voidling came out and did some pretty nasty damage to her. She better get out of there. Oh, man, I thought that he was about to get a stun on her. That was close.
Yeah, he wasn't nearly close enough. Yeah.
Nah, I thought he was going to flat well. Does he? I'm sure he has. Well, yeah, he does. So I wasn't sure if he's going for it. Probably wouldn't have done enough damage, though, so that makes sense.
Now, I'm just taking a look down at Seth. It is a very similar lane. We do have Soraka and Ash down here, as well as Poppy, but we have a Cho'Gath actually comboing with that Poppy this time. We didn't have that Alistar, because he did get banned this round. No more Alistar. He arguably did a great job keeping Poppy alive and dominating that bottom lane. But now it does look like we are going to resolve ourselves to a 2-1-2 scenario. But I do think Taric is going to be wandering around at least a little bit more, as he's just going to go lane to lane, do some healing, some stuns, keep people away. Now, you did say Evelynn, you know, she tried that level 2 gank, and she didn't really do anything too important. But at the same time, she chased this Malzahar off the line, and then even just entice him a little bit with that little wide goose case. Not that she was really expecting Tarek to be there, but at the same time, you look at Atlanta, level 4, and we just had Isfahan hit 3. So it's a decent little advantage. Plus Lightning, he's only still 2. I can only assume Evelyn's at least 3 by now.
Yeah, so Evelyn is actually, she had to go back to the base. She was low health, so she's level 2, going back to pick up those mini golems again. She's got a health potion as well, so not a lot. She's not going to be able to jungle full time. However, she will be able to get a little bit of extra XP there. Let's look at the farm here. Urgot is just dominating the middle lane, but at the same time, so is Corki. They're both dominating. I mean, they're both able to farm from decent distance and safety. And as long as the Corki can dodge the Urgot's Q spell, he'll be fine in the lane. So hopefully no First Blood's given away by OGB this time.
Lightning rush.
Man, but there's a bit of a roaming stun coming down here. Going to be a little bit of damage going down on Urgot, just giving a little bit more lane control to that Corki. So that's pretty good overall. Not going to be able to gank him completely, but every little bit counts. And Evelyn trying to gank top again. He does have his Voidling ready. He's going to get stunned. And let's see if this... he does flash out. Oh, nice. If that's if that Kidd was able to get a stun off, then he would have been done. But that flash is down, so if she can come back there and catch him one more time, he might actually hit the dust.
It's funny how you're saying, like, Urgot can, you know, get chased off a little bit, give Corki some lane control, but check out Ghettofab's hit points right now.
Oh, wow. He must have landed an EQ combo there. That's what I'm saying. Like, you have
multiple
to
Qs, yeah.
Yeah, definitely. Well, yeah, exactly.
Yeah, but didn't quite
actually
work out. Yeah.
Well, so now that there's no Alistar to heal Poppy up, she's, she obviously doesn't have her Philosopher's Stone yet, so she's taking some pretty good harass. I mean, that's going really well for them. They're pushing that tower hard now, and Evelyn is coming down to try and help out. They might actually be able to get a kill here. Oh, man, but he whiffs it. The Cho'Gath was not able to hit the Ashe with a knockup and pretty much did nothing useful there.
Curious how they didn't try to combo that at all. Like, okay, well, I'm going to go stun and then rupture. No, it's just, okay, I'm going to assume you're going to stun here, but you didn't.
Yeah, he just completely misjudged where that rupture should have landed. So.
Well, the double range aspect is actually doing really good up against both Corki and Poppy. Cho'Gath and Poppy. I mean, they could just harass him right out of there. Look at the farm. 12 kills there for Poppy, as well as only 13 there for Cho'Gath, as compared to Ashe, 41.
Yeah, she's doing a really good job of farming. That's what she needs to do in this game, so she's going to be fine. The thing I'm worried about is that top lane is actually not even doing that well against Kidd. He's actually out farming the Malzahar, who has the control with Tarek. I feel like Malzahar should have way more CS than he does right now, just based on the fact that he should have free farm. But at the same time, Kidd is strong. He's got range. It's hard for them to push him out.
True, but we've also had Evelyn come up twice to gank him, twice chasing him out of lane, at least for a little bit, and every little bit snowballs and counts to a good degree. So right now, yeah, he's level 5. Tarek is also hanging around as well. He's level 4. Now, that's not really going to, you know, affect the creep count at all, but, I mean, right now, Atlanta 6 is looking pretty strong. He might be able to just combo down Isfahan through Lightning in a little bit.
It's possible, but Istvan's got a Doran's Ring. He's fairly tanky. He's going to have to take some harass first. I mean, he's not going to be able to take him down for full health. His flash is down. I don't know how much longer. I don't really have a timer on it, but...
it's a 4 minute or so time.
He should be fine, yeah. As far as his Ashe here, she's going to have a little bit harder time harassing now because... maybe not. She's going to have to switch focus to Cho'Gath. Before, she was harassing that Poppy, but Poppy now has the Philosopher's Stone, and she should be fine.
Okay, well, Isfahan actually getting hit.
That's
close. Oh, there we go.
Wow. Ouch. That Ignite just barely taking off the last bit of her health. Mm-hmm. Pretty nasty. So I guess she came into gank and it turned around on her, didn't it?
Definitely. Like, she unloaded that combo there onto Isfahan, but he didn't even have that ultimate ready. If he had that ultimate ready, could have easily thrown it down on Atlanta for a huge chunk of damage. But yeah, Lightning with that heal, the stun, the crystal shatter, it's did him a really good job right there. And one kill, 8.5 minutes into the game, one kill. Oh, AFK message of death. Go away. There we go.
Make sure I'm in my base here. Oh, yeah. Okay, so as you can see, the counter to Evelyn is actually working out fairly well so far. She was able to do a little bit here and there, but it's not really putting her ahead, and they seem to be farming well. Unfortunately, they're not actually beating that Kinnan farm, which you would hope with a dual lane that you would at least be able to zone him a little bit. Not happening. Ash on bottom is, however, doing really well. Actually,
60, yeah.
not as much as Corki, but definitely right up there neck and neck, pretty much.
Well, they're only being separated by a little bit. And Corki, I mean, later on with this phosphorus bomb and machine gun, he said, whoa, we had a big Ash arrow.
Yeah. If it would have hit Urgot, he would have taken some considerable damage from Corki's combo, but yeah.
I didn't even see that arrow. It's just fluke that I found it. But it's not a really big surprise at all that Corki can farm.
Yeah, I mean, Corki just stands behind the creeps and shoots bullets, and he's good to go. And he actually just dodged that Urgot's E spell. So, I mean, I guess he's been doing that. Obviously, he got hit by it once, and he had to be. That's how strong Urgot is. I mean, he lands a combo, and you're pretty much in trouble.
Yeah, and he has that Tear of the Goddess, so rocking 1,000 mana already. He's not going to be leaving that lane anytime soon unless he gets some big harass. But, I mean, we did have Evelynn as the first pick here for complexity. And, yeah, with the Soraka Taric, the two healers in both lanes, it's making her very hard to go grab this. I mean, if we had, instead of Taric being up here with Istvan, instead we had, like, a jungler, would have been a very different story. You know, like Istvan would have at least died twice by now.
That's definitely true, and so it's really smart of them to have picked up what they did, and they're going to be fine as the game goes into a bit later game. And the Evelynn knew that she couldn't really gank too well, so she's actually jungling now. She's level 5. It's going to be a little bit behind.
Yeah, level 9 on Corki here in the mid, 8 on Urgot, 9 now. And up top, I mean, Atlanta again, 8, Istvan 7, and down south, I mean, Ashe and Peterfile 7-6. So yeah, she's a little under, but at the same time she did do some roaming, and unfortunately it just did not work out for her. So you gotta recoup it somehow.
Yeah, she's a great jungler. Just they did nerf her early game jungle, but if she can just jungle up right, she's at a good level to start jungling now. She is going to be coming down for a gank down bottom. She's stealth right there. She's probably going to open up on this Ashe. Ashe is going to get healed by Soraka, most likely. I don't think they're going to pick up this kill unless they can get this knockoff, which she does dodge. Going to be some good damage going down overall, but not going to be able to pick anything up. And Ashe actually may... No, never mind. I thought she was going to arrow and turn that around. That could have been pretty bad for them.
I think they learned from their last game what happened when you carelessly arrow. But you notice that she turned around and attacked that Cho'Gath as he came
gunning
for
Soraka. Soraka's about to get jumped on.
Oh, yeah?
I don't think it's a good idea for her too, because Corki will jump in there and get that kill. She's half health with a red. She's just going to follow Soraka around and wait for Soraka to get in a bad position. So I don't know. We're going to have to see if it actually hurt. Her stealth is probably going to wear off pretty soon.
Well, if she stays there with Peterfile, she's about to go find this Ashe. She's actually...
Up top, though, it looks like Atlanta flashing in, going for the ultimate, and they're going to try and take out the Taric. They're kind of...
Nope,
they switched to Istvan.
Now.
Oh, there we go. There swap. Oh, and he flashes out. He's probably going to be okay. And, oh, that was really ballsy for Atlanta. He was actually probably going to... he almost died to that ignite. That was really, really close. Really ballsy of him to do that. And, okay, so middle lane is getting pushed really hard now due to that fact that Urgot went up top. So they're just going to take 100% advantage of that. Very smart play overall. Whenever one lane leaves, if you don't follow them, you need to be pushing. And that's what Corki's doing here. He's going to take this middle tower, maybe. I think Urgot's going to get there just in time to pick up a kill. If
we have a ward there so we can see him, yeah.
Oh, they can see Evelynn?
No, we saw Urgot coming down.
Yeah. So either way, he did lots of damage to that turret. Next time he pushes like that, he's going to take it out. Mm-hmm. That was actually not too bad because there was no gank up top, and he lost lots of HP on that tower.
No, there was a gank up top. It just didn't work. We do have a purple ward, actually, top now. So no more surprise Evelynn fun. And actually, we have a purple ward here in the mid as well. Do we have one bottom? No,
purple ward for Evelynn, that's good.
Yeah, no purple ward bottom, but we definitely have one in there in the mid, in the top. So, yeah, definitely trying to limit the use of this Evelynn, trying to restrict her there to the jungle. Last we saw her, she was kind of hanging around mid. I'd like to say defending mid.
Yeah, she was hanging around mid to try and do something, but she ended up taking a lot of damage. I saw that. She's still low health, trying to jungle a little bit. Doesn't have any buffs or anything. There are no wards down at all. Oh, wow, Atlanta get arrowed by Ashe. Really great arrow from across the map, and he's destroyed 100%. They're probably going to take this tower if Urgot doesn't go to help out. There's like two waves of creeps, as well as a Malzahar and a Taric. Evelyn's gonna
and a
come in here, but
catapult.
she's still low health. She can literally get insta-gibbed right now, and this is a bad idea for her to even be here. I think she's just trying to soak up some experience before that tower dies.
There
goes
the mid
tower. At the same time, middle tower did go down. Like I said, it took so much damage. All he had to do was hit it a few times. OGB is actually doing really good this game. They countered Evelyn so well that they're getting that lane control. Oh, look at this! And then the East Bell does pop to Evelyn and might actually kill her! Wow, no way, dude. She has like 10 HP.
What, in top lane, I assume?
Jumped onto her after it killed the minion and almost killed her. I don't know if you saw that or
no,
not.
No, I didn't see anything. I was like, what's going on? I don't see anything.
So hard, because there was no way he would have even known why he killed her. That was hilarious. I would have been really sad for Evelyn if she died right there. That would have been hilarious. Okay.
Yeah,
anyways.
You were getting all excited, and it's like, oh, huh, but I didn't see anything. It's like, huh.
Yeah, it was exciting because she was standing there trying to soak up the XP while she was stealth, and I guess she wasn't expecting it to jump on her while she was stealth. Okay, so there's a fight going down here. Urgot getting caught, but he does have flash, so he flashed on the wall. Very good job for him to get away. At the same time, very bad job getting caught and having to use your flash and lose that dragon. I'm pretty sure they're going to get dragon. Is that what they're doing?
Dragon's already down, man.
Okay, so they already got Dragon. They're taking the blue as well, stealing their buffs. Evelyn probably getting seen here. I don't know if they have a...
Nope.
Do they?
Nope, there's no purple there. We don't have any oracles, but we do have all five teammates here. We see that Cho'Gath because he threw down that spell onto Koma, and we did see people jumping, running around through those bushes. I think we are just going to retreat right now. It does look like we are going to retreat. You guys are about to check out that dragon and get very saddened by that fact.
Yes, they are very saddened. They just saw that they do not have dragon. Yep. And I'm imagining Ash had just used her arrow. That's why y'all backed. Is that correct? She used it on Urgot.
I didn't see an arrow go down on Urgot.
Oh, I'm thinking that might have been why they backed, because OGB, they're pretty strong right now. At the same time, they're a little bit split, so it's a good idea. If they don't want to be
I could tell somehow, right?
There's no need for them to overextend. They already had dragon. There's no point in risking a fight there that they could have lost and they could have won. Like, no point at all.
Okay.
This Ash is, look at this. Look at this on bottom, man. She is harassing like a boss. It's just massive, massive harass going out here.
Okay, so Ash didn't have her ult, so she had to have used it probably on the Urgot, as he did say, although I came too late to the fight, I guess, to see it. But she does have it up again, so that's what? It's a 90-second cooldown? 60-second cooldown?
Yeah, it's something like that. I don't know. Depends on the...
A minute and a half ago. Yeah, probably the very beginning of the Urgot fight. It's probably used for initiation. Yeah.
So you can use your arrow and kill someone mid and then go back and then come back and she'll pretty much have it ready again. So it doesn't take long.
It's a little overpowered, but not really. I don't want people quoting me saying that, yeah.
It's only overpowered if you can land it every time on the right target. So there you go.
A little bit of a skill there.
Anyway, so actually two towers down from OGB. They're doing really well. Not only do they have a dragon, they've got two kills, they've got two towers. This could be going into game three if they keep it up, but it is still early, only 16 minutes. We haven't had any true team fights yet. We almost had one there at the dragon. They've been pushing bottom lane so hard, but this Taric might actually get caught if he's not careful.
Well, this time around, I mean, Ash is doing a much better job, you know, with the farm, with the harass. There's another big arrow.
Arrow going down, no
follow-up. But hey, why not? You got the mana because of Soraka. You got the health. Thanks again, Soraka. Without that counter, Alistar, I mean, this bottom lane has been doing good stuff. She already has that BF sword ready to go here. 17 minutes instead of the 22, 23 minute mark we saw last game. And the creep kill score is what? 90. Where is she? 129.
129, yes. So I told you last game it was all Alistar. Alistar just destroyed them in that lane. Kept Poppy farming all she wanted, but at this time she can't farm as much as she wants. She's getting harassed crazy. Only 66 to Ashes, you know, basically twice as much. With much different story last game. So doing a very good job, Ashes, and not only that, but they countered Evelyn with that strategy there. And Evelyn hasn't gotten any kills at all, so she's not ahead. She doesn't even she still hasn't even built her first item. I mean, as far as
that's kind of poor, yeah.
So it's going to be a while before she gets Sheen. It's going to be like 20 minutes plus, even more than that, really. Probably going to be like 25, 30 minutes before she even has a Sheen. It's kind of heartbreaking.
Well, to me, she has 36 creep kills with a Vampiric Scepter and a Mad Dreads. Is that about right?
That's what I'm saying. She's going for the Wriggles, and she hasn't even built it yet. So
yeah, it's 18 minutes in.
She's going to have to be careful. I don't think Ash has her arrow because she wasted earlier. Nope. But this tower.
Oh, yeah, she does. Yeah!
Very nice. So this Poppy's going to be probably dying. I don't think
so. I don't think so. They'd have to use a flash at this point.
Yeah,
she's
not slowed, so she can get away.
We do see that Urgot there because we did throw out a Hawkshot. So, yeah. Very wise to
Yeah.
get out. Clairvoyance going down as well, but there's
So
no one
they're
around
picking
for me,
the
so.
Baron over here. Are you guys going for that?
Three of them are.
Yeah, I don't know, because there's a ward there. We saw y'all going, and that was a ping going down. There's four people headed that direction.
We see Urgot, yeah.
I'm just sitting in my base at level one, just waiting for combat.
Baron's down to half, but Atlanta's gonna jump in here.
Oh no, this is
Lightning.
going for the kill, but don't think he's gonna be able to get it. He's actually gonna get caught. Really bad at move overall. His team was not close enough to take advantage of that. He was actually trying to catch Taric, but Taric did flash over. Ended up baiting him out, getting the kill. This might actually be bad for Complexity if they get caught again. LGB is actually trying to B right now. I think they're just harassing a little bit, trying to scare them into going for Baron. But that was really good. OGB picked up another kill, so now three ahead. Gonna continue farming. Let's see how well Corki is doing on farm. 178. Oh my gosh! So yeah,
Yeah,
he's doing really
he's a powerhouse at this point. I mean, with the Phosphorus Stone, Yeah, thanks, Harry Potter. Phosphorus Bomb, as well as the machine gun, he's just cleaning up these creep waves, no problem. And of course, you know, those, I call them the Big Bertha missiles, but I don't quite think that's the real name for
Well,
them.
I think that the every sixth missile is a Big Bertha.
Yeah, well, with his missiles, I mean, exceptional range, he just back up, no problem, not get harassed,
Big
still last
weapon.
hit like a boss. And look at this, Manamune, Riggle's Lantern, still only boots the speed. I guess he's not too worried with Valkyrie, as well as Flash. And what's his other one? Ghost? Nope, Cripple. Or, well, Exhaust. Cripple.
Yeah.
Hee hee.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's doing himself quite well. He has two wards, as well as an amplifying two.
Oh, stun going down on Kennen. And
And
an
another
arrow
one.
hits. Well, finally a good arrow going down. He's slowed. He's stunned. He's dead. And so
Wow.
he's not going to get away from that one. Really good job. So, fourth kill for OGB. Doing a really, basically a complete turnaround
Reverse,
of
yeah.
what happened last game. And so, apparently, dual lane is the way to go for them. Well, I guess if there's an Evelynn
What
anyway.
happens when you pick Evelynn first, I
That's what.
suppose.
That's why you bet Alistar, kids. Anyways.
Or
So
pick
there's an
Evelynn
Oracle's for
first, yeah.
OGB as well. I can see them. She's gonna see this ward here in the bush and take it out. No more vision. They're gonna get this dragon. I think that Complexity wants to fight here. They want to pick this kill up. They're gonna have to be aggressive. However, they're already getting caught. They don't even
Oh.
have their whole team here, but they know that there
Oh!
is a from top.
Combo! Oh,
Oh,
combo!
nice
Oh!
flash there, but she's gonna die anyways. There is an Evelynn there to pick that up. And so, wow, Complexity does pick up a kill finally, and OGB is gonna have to back out of there. Oh, getting swapped out. So Urgot trying to take a kill here. He's gonna take a lot of damage. At the
Yeah.
same time, Evelynn comes in to kind of pick up a kill, and I don't know if Poppy actually stunned him against the wall. She pushed him,
No,
but it
yeah,
didn't
she
look like
pushed him.
it, he was there for very
But
long.
he also has no mana to get out of that. He's already used the flash going down.
All right.
Urgot gonna pick up
Got
that, no
it.
problem.
No way. No way he's getting away. Very good job by Complexity. They're very good players, and it's gonna be close. OGB's gonna have to be careful. I mean, they had four people there at Dragon, and it was really risky for them to go for it since Malzahar was pushing top. They should have just kind of defended while oh goodness. There's an Astro kind of randomly on that. I don't know what the point of that was. There's
Man,
no one there to engage on that.
prolonging the inevitable.
Yeah, the inevitable random arrow from Ash, as usual.
Oh, that's a little mean, but yeah, it was a 4-on-4.
I'm not gonna say that I'm any better with Ash. I just like to be silly sometimes.
But
Okay, so Complexity is gonna go ahead and pick up this dragon,
first dragon
and
of the game for them. Yeah.
Yeah, Malzahar is still pushing top. He wants to take this tower out. I don't
Yeah.
think he's gonna be able to. I mean,
No.
he's able to farm a lot, which is good for him. But let's see, 129. Even with all that time up there, he still can't catch up with Corki and Ash. Not that it matters. They're just so far ahead.
Well, they're able to clear creep waves pretty much in two shots.
Oh yeah, they're doing very well.
I do have OGB. They are gathering up here. It does look like another attempt going to go down here at the Baron. Now, last time the three of them, without Ashe or Soraka, were able to take them down to half. Maybe they're just trying to bait it out at this point. We did throw down some wards. I do see that giant eyeball, though. The Eye of Sauron looking at us.
Yeah, the Sauron eye is all seeing, so it's good stuff.
So I guess no Baron attempt there, but the three of them before, at like, you know, the 18, 19 minute mark, was able to get them down to half. So if we can bait this out, maybe get an Oracle's running and, bleed you guys dry of wards, might be able to actually snag that in the next 5, 6 minutes. Could
Yeah,
be
it
a
looks like
big pushing advantage.
Evelynn actually has an Oracle. She's trying to go around searching out those wards as well. I don't know if you guys have any wards there, but yep, there it is. So we are going to see that ward, and
Because they
she apparently
how'd you
just
see
missed.
that? Yeah.
What? She missed it. They didn't kill it, did they?
I still, if you're talking about the ward in the bush, just south of them, yeah.
Kill it.
Nah, it's still there.
She didn't kill it. What a huge mistake by Evelyn, just walking out of the bush, not killing that. That seems really dumb. I don't know. Whatever. So that Ash Arrow did hit Cho'Gath,
yeah.
So it didn't really do anything once again.
Yeah.
But they're going to have to play it safe here. If they can catch somebody with Malzahar's ult and get a Taric stun, there could be a kill picked up for OGB. They're just going to play it safe. I mean, Complexity, they're not out of the game completely. They did lose the early game, and they are out two towers and a couple of dragons, but they're not out of the game yet. It's still anyone's game at this point. One mistake for OGB could spell the end of the game. Evelyn is not necessarily super duper far behind. I mean, she's got a kill and an assist and 39 CS. The 39 CS is not helping her out, but at the same time, you know, if she can get a Sheen built up and eventually that Trinity Force, she'll be decent. But until then, she's not going to be that useful into the team fights.
Well, speaking of team fights, I saw that Ash hero go, and nobody was really able to follow up. I was like, oh, are we going to be falling into that habit we saw the first game with, you know, just those awkward Ash arrows forcing initiation?
Yeah.
So
exactly.
I was fearful. But no, nothing
happened. She needs to save it for the Evelyn or the Urgot or even the Kennen, you know? But not the Cho'Gath. I mean, Cho'Gath's a gentleman. He doesn't need to be shot with arrows.
I love when he throws out his silence. He's like, be quiet.
Quiet!
Yeah, it's great.
I mean, people are loud. Use your inside voices, guys. Come on.
Let's see. Let's take a quick look here at around the place for items. Level 14, Malzahar has himself that unusually large rod as well as a blasting wand. So he'll be finishing that up pretty quick. Soraka going again. Heart of gold stacking. As we do find Cho'Gath hiding in the bush. He's a big guy. I wonder how he hid there. But, I don't know. Taric looks like he has himself that Heart of Gold as well as a Philo Stone. And Como, you know, nice Infinity Edge. Nice and early this time as opposed to last game where it came really just a little too late. But Corki is the man. Look at him. 216 creep kills with a kill. And look at that. Man Immune with that Riggles. We already had that. But the Sheen, that guy should be finished up within fairly short order.
Yeah, he's going to go for Trinity. He's got a Manamune, and then he can build whatever he wants. He can either go defense, or he can go for more damage at that point, if he'd like. And Kennen, he doesn't have a full item build, but he's trying to work it up. He did do the same thing, the Hextech Revolver for the lane sustainability, and it actually worked out really well for him. He did win the lane phase, I think, even though he was versus two people.
Mm-hmm.
This fight right here is going to come down to Ash landing a good arrow, I believe. And then you're going to have some good follow-up with the Malzahar. But at this point, I feel like Complexity might be getting stronger as far as the team fight is concerned, unless they get caught in a bad position. Because you got Cho'Gath, who can just soak up so much damage. And he's not going to be... I mean, he's not like he can't dish damage. If he builds all damage and to late game, then eventually he's going to be pretty weak. But at this point in the game, it's only mid game, so he's going to be kind of annoying for them. And then Poppy can pop in there. She doesn't have a Trinity built up, but she does have a Sheen and a Fade, so she should be able to stick to a target really well. If she can get Ash down, then it's going to spell the end of Ash, of course.
Yep. If.
Yeah, definitely.
Hasn't worked yet this game, but you know, the theory is there. I do see Evelyn has for herself that Wriggles, so good job. That should help her out a little bit in that jungle, but she's looking pretty underpowered at this point.
Oh, she is. She needs a Sheen. And pretty soon, she really needs a Trinity at this point, but she did have to go for that. I mean, that's just the way it is. I mean, you get countered and you're done, so.
We do see you there, coming into our jungle. How dare you?
I was like, what? I'm at the base. What are you talking about? No, yes, we are coming to the jungle, and I don't think she saw a ward.
There wasn't any.
Did she walk past it?
Well, there was a ward over by Cho'Gath in the middle brush, the middle southern brush.
Uh-oh. Looks like Evelyn, coming in and killing Istvaan there.
Dying for it.
Yeah, definitely.
Oh,
and
I think
really low. So is Cho'Gath. This is going to be really bad for them. The entire team for Complexity is low. They're going to have to run away. Urgot is not low, but he's in the back, and he's going to get slowed by Ash. There's no way he's getting away. He's going to have to stand there and fight and keep their team busy. And Atlanta's just about to get away. Oh, no! Poor Poppy. She was trying to teleport away. She knew she couldn't get away. She got seen by that... Oh, goodness.
Yeah, we saw her. I just saw her there in the bush. She's like trying to teleport. Like, that's not going to work.
Yeah, that was kind of funny. The Get Fab just came up and shot
a... Yeah, you guys comboed really hard onto Malzahar. He died really quick, and then you basically, all five of you, had to run away, and only two of you got out of that. Actually, only one of you got out of it, because Evelyn died really quick. She's already alive again. But Kennen, Kennen.
Oh, they go for Bear now. So I guess if OGB doesn't, I mean, sorry, if Complexity doesn't get here quick, you guys are gonna pick this up. You've got quite a bit of damage, and it's going down fast. There's only two people even remotely close. And Lena's about there. I don't know if he even has flash, so it's not like he can flash over and steal it. Evelyn's there. She's not close enough to. I don't think you guys are gonna pick this up. I don't think that there's any way we can stop this. Yep.
There we go. Boom.
So OGB picking up that Baron. Really good job by them. 3-8 with Baron. Several dragons and three towers down to one.
I think we're only two dragons ahead. Because dragon's up right now, unless you've killed it
more
again.
Than, I guess.
But two dragons ahead means it's, 3-1 or 4-2 for dragons?
I don't know how many. I think it's
Well, is it up right now?
I don't know. I think it is. I see the icon.
I see the icon. Oh, if you see it and I see it, it's up.
Yeah, it's definitely up then, yo.
So, yeah, I'm pretty sure there's only a two-dragon difference.
Yeah, we just did a clairvoyance there at that dragon to see if you guys are there. You're not. Yep. So I guess you guys are just picking up your jungle, or what are you guys doing?
Yeah, jungle, creeping. Everyone went to town. I mean, that Baron doesn't go down without a fight. So let's see. We have Ionian Boots of Lucidity, which is still a weird name to me, but for Peterfile, and a needlessly large rod. So Soraka could be throwing out the big heels. Fairly shortly, as well as a Rabadon's coming out here from Malzahar, so he went and finished that up. Three Doran's rings for him. Really likes that laning phase. And the Zeo has now been completed with Ash, as well as another pickaxe with that Infinity Edge. So
she's going on for that armor pin now.
Yeah, I could have expected the Zeal to go into the Phantoms first, but yeah, I guess not.
Well, Zeal is good enough by itself. You don't necessarily need to build into a Phantom right away. With the combination, well, I mean, with that, sorry. With Cho'Gath and I'm guessing Kennen now, because Kennen has a Zhonya, so that's kind of armorish too. She just wants to penetrate as much as she can. Wow, they're just pushing these. Yeah, they're pushing these towers down pretty far now. Oh, there goes a nice initiate on Kennen. If they can start, yep, there it is, the Malzahar stun on Atlanta. Definitely going to go down. Very good job initiating that. And now they're going to be pushing back, trying to at least pick up a few more kills. Not going to happen, though, with all of the heals. You've got not only a Taric, but you've got a Soraka. Good luck trying to kill anyone with that team comp. Goodness, such pushing power. You've got Baron buff. Taylor's going to go down. So is Inhibitor. Four people dead. Urgot's the only one alive. They might actually be able to push this down to one or two turrets from the inner portion as well.
I think they just win right now.
It's possible, but you guys have about 10 seconds. They're not going to be able to push both towers down. But then again, sure. They might. I don't know. They might be able to.
Now we're going to go kill Urgot instead.
Yeah, it's over. So hey, that's going to be GG.
There's an angel to go kill right there.
Yeah, so that's going to be GG. They've got enough healing. They could just stay there anyways if they wanted to.
So what happened there? Complete reversal to that first game. 13-5, and it's over within half hour. I mean, we've pushed this entire lane and the Nexus turrets.
I believe this is going to be my first game that goes to three games in all my ESL casting.
Well,
I'll be honest. So I'll tell you what happened was they got countered. I mean, straight up countered.
Yeah, Alistar was really a big part of that strategy for Poppy. And without
it, Ash had good arrows this game.
She's thrown decent arrows. I wouldn't say they're groundbreaking, but...
Well, they were good enough to win some fights, so that's what matters. And so this game does go to Complexity. Sorry, OGB, not Complexity. I'm on Complexity's team. That doesn't mean I'm winning.
No, I got to win both games. Lucky me.
Yeah, see, I'm I'm just bad luck, apparently.
All right, but yeah, so there you go, guys. You know, having a very Alistar-dependent strat and having him banned and then taking Evelyn first pick, getting countered really hard there. You know, good stuff for Oh God Bear showing that, hey, they're not going to go out of this without a fight. They are tied for first in the Premier League, and that is what the Game of the Week does tie into here, the National ESL. And Complexity, I think, is fifth or sixth right now with 9 points. We do have OGB up there, 18 with solo mid. So, game three, as he did say, you know, it is a best of three series. And when we're tied, we got to go get that last one. So stick with us, guys, here. National ESL, Four Court Jester, and Colby Cheese. And, you know, let's go see.